I declare open the Economy and Infrastructure public hearing for the inquiry into the use of school buses in rural and regional Victoria.
There has to be some kind of framework in place for the safety of all students and the safety of all people catching the bus.
Our recommendation is that there be redesign of existing regional public transport services so that they are integrated.
Years and years and years, our community has said that we need more public transport in our community. But again, it's about making sure that we're not compromising one program to fit another.
The African young people have been recommending to the Victorian government to do what we call activating the downtime and using those buses to deliver more services. For over 10 years, young people have been saying this.
There is no shortage of vehicles anywhere, I would suggest, across Australia. It's how they're being used.
Did I understand correctly that New South Wales has free transport for all students?
You have to meet eligibility requirements under the school student transport scheme. But even if you're not eligible for that free travel, there are school term passes, which are nominal cost, say $50 a term, or it's very low in price.
Would that be means tested, I assume?
No, there's no means testing. There's no co-payment.
I just want to tease that out a little bit and say, well, if there's a gap, is it the school bus program that's the right vehicle, if I could use that terminology, to close that gap?
The possibility of using them as community transport services, which, you know, similarly doesn't necessarily have the same public transport regulations about the quality of the service, but is another way and potentially a cost-effective way to utilise those assets in a community.
So we're talking about two options. One is allowing more people onto the existing school buses on their way to and from school, you know, at 9 a.m. in the morning and 3:30 in the afternoon. And then when those school buses aren't used to drive school students around, using those buses, the physical buses, to deliver more routes and services.
Do you think it's insurmountable that we can't convince people that we can do this safely?
You're not going to be able to convince everyone that they can do it safely. And I think it is 100% a valid concern for parents and carers.
Sure. And how would you respond to those concerns that parents in particular are expressing around the safety of kids?
You know, whether that be having to have a working with children's check or, you know, police check.
There's 400 public transport bus routes in Victoria. If we opened up to the school bus routes, it becomes 1,600.
Mm.
So the ability for apprentices to get to work, kids going off to TAFE.
So it's about saying that post-education students with a pass would be able to access, and the school bus coordinators are actually supportive of that one.
In my mind, I'd be suggesting, because it is a school bus, people should really have to pre-book in a perfect world. How does New South Wales do it? Can people stand at a bus stop?
Yes.
Oh, so you get random people jumping on?
Yes. Generally speaking, though, in a lot of the smaller communities, people are mostly known to each other anyway.
Yes.
So it's not like there's a lot of... Yes. Complete strangers.
Is it left up to bus drivers what size buses they can run to put capacity on and so on?
No, it's not just left entirely up to the operator to make that decision. We work with them looking at the student numbers on their service, what would be the appropriate size vehicle for them to use.
If we sort of said, let's see if we can ease this in, if we can trial it in, say open it up, say, to TAFE students.
What we'd like to see is a place-based approach to moving public transport forward. So it might be that rather than a staged rollout of cohorts consistent across the state, it's different regions take a different approach.
Public transport in many places around the world, including here in Victoria and domestically in other parts of Australia, are moving to a more on-demand service.
All I would say is that yes, it's a great idea and should definitely be looked at for regional communities, but do your homework, make sure you cost that out properly, because the downside is also, you know, not quite great either.
That concludes today's public hearings for the Economy and Infrastructure Committee.